Greetings. I was reading today and what I found was amazing. This is Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, and he said, among other things, "The corpus of Islamic texts and ideas that we have sacralized over the centuries are antagonizing the entire world. That it is not possible that 1.6 billion people, referencing Muslims, should want to kill the rest of the world's inhabitants, that is 7 billion people, so that the Muslims themselves may live. And that Egypt, or the Islamic world, is being torn, destroyed, it is being lost, and it is being lost by our own hands. In Islam, there are some rational people. They are sincere people. They only follow Islam because that is all they know. That is the only thing they are allowed to know. The corpus or body of Islamic texts are antagonizing the entire world. This poor man can see the destruction that is coming. That it is not possible that 1.6 billion Muslims should want to kill the rest, 7 billion people, so that they themselves may live. He staggers at the very real path he now sees that Islam is forcing on the world. But he has no clue, no insight, no chance to even understand, because the Islam he imagines, the Islam he fantasizes, is not the Islam that Islam was designed to be. Islam is flowering into what Satan planned, and what God foresaw and warned about. Or do you really think it is just a coincidence? The Bible said Christians would be beheaded by the Antichrist. And the only religion on earth that beheads Christians is Islam. And Islam is doing so with greater frequency and more zeal every day. I was not surprised that jihadis twittered that flooding in Texas was a curse for the cartoons. ISIS recruiters tweeting pics of Texas flooding, calling it punishment for profit cartoon contest. But do not get all indignant. This is not very different from comments I read regarding New Orleans, or the 2004 Christmas tsunami that wiped out Muslims in Indonesia. Christians, you need to open your eyes. It is far too easy to rejoice when the wicked perish. But that is not the heart of God. John 4:35. Do you not say, there are yet 4 months, and then comes the harvest? Behold, I say to you, lift up your eyes and look on the fields, that they are white for harvest. Already he who reaps is receiving wages and is gathering fruit for life eternal, so that he who sows and he who reaps may rejoice together. Let that sink in. Matthew 9:38. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out workers into his harvest. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send the Son into the world to judge the world, but that the world might be saved through him. We all have that feeling of wanting to see evil punished. And then we tremble and panic when the thought occurs to us, maybe we do not meet the threshold of goodness either. The world is unraveling. The birth pangs have begun. This is just as the Word of God foretold 2,000 years ago. Do not look to America as your Savior. You need the only real Savior in your heart. The God who foretold this, brother, is the only God you can appeal to. And his name is not Allah. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.